Broadcast Center in Los Angeles. This is KCAL 9 News at 4.
Now at 4, on the day the U.S. crosses the threshold of 10 million coronavirus cases, a drug maker reveals its vaccine could be a game changer. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Susie Sa.
And I'm Juan Fernandez. This is KCAL 9 News at 4, and we're streaming on CBSN Los Angeles. Well, while Wall Street and the world are excited about the development, scientists and even Governor Newsom say, hold on.
Yeah, they warned there's still a long road ahead. KCAL 9's Hermela Aragawi live in Studio City this afternoon with what Pfizer is saying about its vaccine. Hermela.
Susie Wan, Pfizer is calling this a historic moment, and experts say it is, but it's still just one of many steps that the drug maker has to take before the general population can have access to the vaccine and before most of us can feel the impact.
We have been working basically around the clock for 8 months. This is one of the biggest, if not the biggest, medical advance in the last 100 years.
Drug maker Pfizer says early data shows its experimental COVID-19 vaccine is more than 90% effective and that it will submit an emergency use authorization with the FDA once its trial is completed in 2 weeks.
I would suspect that if we get going and start the first rounds of vaccination in January, for us to really have a significant impact in the population is going to take till, you know, into the summer.
Dr. Nicholas Testa, who's not involved with Pfizer's trial, says the early data is promising, but that the complete results must be published and peer-reviewed. And even if all that goes well, the need to wear masks and social distance will not change until probably mid-next year.
What people need to remember is it's going to be the ramping up of the vaccine, and it's not going to be a ramping down of the other measures.
Dr. Testa says the most vulnerable, frontliners, the elderly, and people with chronic conditions will get the vaccine in the initial rollout.
I would get it. I think by the time it gets around to most of the population, it'll be safe enough for all of us.
I just don't think I would get it because it just feels very rushed, and I rather quarantine, self-isolate, kind of just do what we've been doing.
But Dr. Testa says though he understands those fears, they're not scientifically founded. He says the most common side effects are mild symptoms of the virus like aches, fatigue, and low-grade fever. The most serious side effects, which are usually a severe allergic reaction or autoimmune response, are very rare. And so are long-term side effects of vaccines.
I know people will have anxiety about the safety of the vaccine. I honestly feel that the vaccine will be safe and it will be far better than what's going on with COVID.
Pfizer says it has 50 million doses ready to go. Half of those will go to Americans. And the drug company says it can manufacture 1.3 billion doses by next year. Live in Studio City, Hermela Aragawi, KCAL 9 News.
All right, Hermela, thank you very much. Well,